Imagine he allows the person to hear the voice of God. Quite remarkable in that. And every prophecy was directed at what ministry he will get on to. See, it was he, and he's still ministering there to the next generation. We had over 110, nearly 120 next generation leaders from most districts of Sri Lanka. I was very personally grateful to see how much they were ministered to. So your turn is 12th, that is this Tuesday. Don't miss it. Any family there, he will personally also sit down because he said that is his greatest strength. So God bless you. So today my message is making peace with your pain. Now, will you repeat the title, Making Peace with Your Pain? Now, if you have never had a pain, this would be not relevant. Anyone who has never had a pain, so no hands up, which means each of us has had some pain and a pain that you will remember of, specifically. Then, if you are really determined to have a fight with your pain also, then also you will not be interested in this message. Any occasion you remember that you have had a fight with your pain, and that pain could have been a person, a disease, isn't it? Unfair treatment. You understand the context of the message? Yes. Daniel, in the lion's den, different aspects of pain we come across. Losing someone we deeply loved too early would be we would feel it was very unfair if you lose a loved one very early. Or betrayal, someone who you're very close to. And we define pain always casting ourselves in a good light, but sometimes we can define pain condemning ourselves also. Isn't it? So you got this hope, huh? So let's now pinch your neighbor a little hard, not to draw blood, but till you get his spinal thalamic tract stimulated. That's the medical tract that carries pain. Okay. So now you know why doctors would clap and they don't clap, they'll remember all this. So why did I ask you to pinch? Because every living being feels pain. So if you felt pain, you will be thankful you are not dead. Only so there are some people who have made peace with their pain. In that community, everybody has made their peace with pain. Where can you meet such a community? In the cemetery. They have made their permanent peace as far as their body goes. But we know the scripture, Hebrews 9:28, it is appointed unto man to die once and then for judgment. Our soul is not eternal because it had a beginning, but it is immortal. Only God is eternal. Eternal means no beginning, no end. But the human soul, once created, it will not die. It will have an immortal, you know, it will leave our body and go and patience. more with the scope of his character, and grace do not change when suffering comes. As I trust God even in my heart, I let my life speak of hope that extends well beyond what we can see or touch. Just see whether these scriptures will fit with you, and not only the creation. 23:28, not only the creation, but we ourselves who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly as we wait eagerly for an adoption as sons, the redemption of our body. For in this hope we were saved. Now, hope that is seen is not hope, but hope for what is seen. So, hope is hope till it gets realized. That's the meaning of the scripture. Now, reasons for pain. Sin entered the world through human choice. Next one. Reasons for pain. So our first forefather Adam and Eve said, God, Father, we will do things without you, we can manage without you. Now you will agree that that would be very painful if your son said that to you, isn't it? So the power is your son. Three fellows. So does he behave at times as if he can do it on his own? Better. Usually sons follow fathers, gentlemen, and daughters follow mothers. Have you read it anywhere before? You couldn't have, I made it up just now. Yeah. There are some effects like that, but in their second year, first year they want mom to cuddle, usually they want mom to cuddle. If you remember, at the end of second year, they start pushing and doing this, and they want to go and do and find out. They want to research, expand their boundaries. You have to love that. So you put him in a playpen first year, but by about 8 months, he doesn't like that terrible thing called the playpen. So kick at it, new. Then love him, limited, enlarged boundary, to go see, give him an illusion that there's a large space bordering with sofas and so on. He'll get on to it. He feels he has conquered something. He must always, when he is passing from one to two, he must always keep at the boundary something he can get on. Did you understand? Then he gets on to it. He'll peep over the top of it, make sure that he will not fall, or else you have to have, you know, a thick mattress around it. But he has to have this feeling, I got somewhere. They want to do it in their second year, explore the boundaries, test the fence, kick at it, that's part of. And then dad has to tell mom, you know, it's the time they want to explore. Please, you have to love it, you understand? Moms generally try to keep them huddled as possible, which practice they exercise with the husband in time to come. Kids, strike it off the hands, and I didn't say it. So first one, sin entered the world through human choice. Second one, God subjected. So as a result, everything he beautifully created lost the purpose of goodness. Thorns came, poisons came, dust came, toil came, heart came. But after we said, I'll bring my way. Thirdly, Christ came into the world because of his predicament. Fourthly, we are given a chance to share in God's solution. Shall we say together? Father in heaven, because of suffering and pain, you gave each one of us a chance, an opportunity to partner with Jesus Christ the Savior. One more question. So I want to define the worst pain as the pain of our Father seeing me living for less than was informed that many, many Muntala schools have gaming centers just near it, dispensing drugs. Some mixing it with the snacks. This father found him in such a place. Now he desperately hopes he can save the son. That's why they came to me. So I sat with them and spoke hands to the boy, the bright fellow. verifiable truth. Give me a way to appreciate that. Real history, verifiable truth, place, persons, all can be checked up, and even the timeline. So in the record of history, he recorded the history of Israel in 12 books. Two of those books were called Chronicles, meaning what you know as Chronicles. What's a chronicle? A record of history. So this boy's stories, this little bit, is found in 1 Chronicles 4, 9 and 10. Jabez was more honorable than his brothers, which means he had brothers, and God looked at him and God said he is going to a place greater than his brothers. So more honor is more pain. Tell your neighbor, more honor is more pain. Ask your son, is that all right? Sons, you have to make a decision. Ask your son, more honor. And daughters, of course, more honor is more pain. Is that all right? So, this is how it was told to Jabez, was more honorable than his brothers. And his mother named him Jabez, saying, because I bore him with pain. So, the Hebrew word Jabez means pain. So why do you think his mother named him like that? So every time she says, Jabez, come and have your meal. Daniel, what is Jabez hearing? Now when we say Daniel, you only hear Daniel. But if we say Kavit, he will immediately know this has something to do with poetry. The singer Kavit, the praise, you know. Yeah, Kavit, sorry. Forgive me, thank you for the correction. And coming means the praise of the appraisers. But Daniel is a Hebrew word which means judged of God. Samuel means heard of God. Danica means morning glory. How do I know that? Because my granddaughter is also Danica. Yes. So in those languages, they have meaning just the way our language has meaning. So Jabez meant pain. So every time Jabez's mother says, Jabez, come for milk, what does Jabez hear? Kakuma, I will have any more. That's what he listened to here. Pain, come here. That's because. So why do you think his mother named him like that? What might that pain have been? Yes? Yes, Dr. What might that pain have been? It might have been pain of physical labor. She might have gone through real pain. Because he seems to be a child at the end of at least 4 or 5 brothers. And she might have been an elderly lady, isn't it? Then, so Bible is very true. So she might have experienced pain. And Jabez's father is not mentioned. So what other reason may she have had to pay? Father absent. Father did better. Much worse would be father forsaking, isn't it? So this boy, mother called him like that, and he began to hear the story. He might have asked mom, why did you call me this name? My friends are laughing at me that you have given this name to me, isn't it? My mother might have explained. So he made a prayer when he could make a prayer. Now Jabez, say with me, put your name and say, now, your name. One day Jabez said, I am going to live above my name. I am going to live above my mother's prophecy. I am going to live above what my mother felt about me. So say with me, now. So whatever your history has been, whatever your story has been, you are also going to say, now, Jabez. What are the things he did? He called on the God of Israel. So he decided the inner critical voice he bears, carries, resonates, echoes inside him, will be not what his mother said in pain, but will be his destiny mind that switches on joy. It's a switch. There's practical help. It's a switch. So listen to joyful Christian music. Then there are sour incidents in life. You didn't like them. You understand sour, isn't it? Sour is sour. Just that he showed me a sour face. He always has become the hibiki of Kapala Mirku again. Then of course salty is when you are into thrill at all the time on tension. That is not a good position to be. The other one is all the time bitter, painful memories. What are you switching on to? Agreed, we get switched on according to what we go through. Agreed. But I'm telling you, we can train ourselves to raise our pain threshold and don't call things pain unless it is really there. Can you give me a wave of hand? Don't call things pain until it is really there. Don't keep dropping. Anything becomes pain, you know. That was bad, this was bad, very bitter, very bad the way they treated me. So let's say a prayer together. Lord Jesus Christ, I want to practice the switch on to joyful memories. Lord Jesus, I don't want to practice the bitter memories. But so, when you switch on the salty one, you quickly get angry. When there's no need for anger, there's no need for tension, you're all ready to get tensed up, you know. No need. 16, you don't need to get tensed up. You have only one thought. Unless you get the world thing. I don't think you've been there, so don't get tensed up. You have only one thought. You should rest muscle, hopefully, after prayer. So let's pray about those who get into this the salty thing of stress, anger, fast reaction. Lord Jesus, we are praying tonight for anything, anyone who may be having this switch, the salty one, quickly going to anger too fast in Jesus. And Lord, we want to pray for those who are in the sour one, who quickly go to anxiety. Shall we say that together? Lord Jesus, I don't want to switch on anxiety. Finally, Lord Jesus, any bitter, painful memory that is negative, I take it to the cross. Will the worship team come again and we'll sing our old favorite, On the Rugged Cross. Let's take it there. Receive the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart. So here is Jabez. He said, I am going to expect a blessing, not a curse, not a rundown, but a run. God, bless me indeed. And Jabez said it so many times. So his inner critical voice, did you write that down? Inner critical voice. I don't know, you should be writing this thing down. Yeah, these are lecture notes. You are getting it free. Other than what you drop into offering. Inner critical voice. What is your inner critical voice saying? Is it making not sour things sour? Is it making not hot things hot, salty? Is it making not bitter things bitter? Get what I mean? Inner salty voice. What is recorded there interprets everything else according to the record that goes on. It's like a pair of red goggles you are wearing or gloomy goggles you are wearing. Then you look at a coming event or something gloomy goggles. It hasn't happened. But it says the same person who troubled you is going to be there and you are going to have a painful experience. Did you understand that? Present memory projecting to something that has not even happened. So tonight we are going to say, we are taking to the cross. Amazing grace is going to come. I'm going to watch for the switch. Shall we say together? I'm going to watch for the switch. Please repeat. I'm going to watch for the switch. finish. Not to turn to sour, not to turn to salty, not to turn to bitter, but I want to recall the joy of the Lord. And when Israel was very young, they had this memory in Psalm 137, when Israel had lost it all. In David's time, they were the most powerful nation. They lost it all. They were a very clever nation. They always sang. They were great musicians. David the king taught them music. By the rivers of Bethlehem, when we sat down and wept, 137. When we remember the good old days of Zion, upon the billows, in the midst of it, we hung our harps, for they are our captors. Demanded of us songs. In captivity, under demand, songs don't come. Don't be under captivity to your last breath. Please repeat this to your name. Don't be under captivity to your last bad experience. Okay? It might have been a man's exam, a terrible monster called maths. Don't think here. There were some nattos who liked maths. One such is standing and talking, but most sensible people didn't like that. Yeah. Whatever those that took you captivity, incident, bad happening, betrayal, hope disappointing, faith fracturing, love. What happens to love? Love moves. We take it to the cross on a hill. Jabez also said, enlarge my border. Let your hand be with me. Now, one more point. Shall we say together, enlarge my border. But it has a condition. God's hand will be on you all the time. Like a double light. That's the way God will enlarge your border. By keeping his hand on you. That guidance all the time. So that's what God is saying. Enlarge my border, that your hand might be with me all the time, that you would keep me from harm, that it may not pain me. Bless you, that it may not pain me. Which means not that painful things will not come, but you have redefined the threshold of your pain. You see, what you say is pain. You are learning to absorb it. Take it, deflect it to the cross. Pain comes, take it to the Savior. Pain comes, take it to the Savior. Sickness comes, take it to the Savior. Anxiety comes, take it to the Savior. Sour responses come, take it to the Savior. Bitter feelings come, take it to the Savior. He drank it all in one cup in Gethsemane. And he was already sweating blood. Before he went to the cross in Gethsemane, because he drank the dregs of human bitterness. So on a hill, on a
hill.
And exchange in some day for And exchange in some.